Looks functions exactly like original part it's replacing. The original Samsung part failed in less than 2 years. This costs 1/3 the price. Simple snap connector and 2 screw holes line up perfectly. No idea how long it'll last, but for the price you can afford to buy a couple to have on hand. Total time replacing less than 10 minutes. I was not positive that this was the issue, but for $30 and tax, it was worth a try. The oven did not work and gas did not turn on. The temperature was just blinking 150. Replacing the igniter is pretty easy but kind of a pain. There are only 8 screws total to remove. 2 on the outer cover, 2 on the inner cover, 2 on the gas pipe, name, and 2 on the igniter. I dropped 2 of them into the bottom of the stove, but it was simple to retrieve them with a small magnet from a kid's toy. The stove needs to be pulled out to connect the igniter and reinstall the gas pipe. The igniter itself just snaps in place. The hardest part of the replacement is screwing the igniter into the gas pipe inside the oven. The screws are tiny and there is too little space on the bottom for holding the bolt in place. I was able to use a 7mm wrench, but it is tricky to get the bolt in place. In all, it took about 20-30 minutes and a medium amount of cursing at tiny screws. Looks functions exactly like original part it's replacing. The original Samsung part failed in less than 2 years. This costs 1/3 the price. Simple snap connector and 2 screw holes line up perfectly. No idea how long it'll last, but for the price you can afford to buy a couple to have on hand. Total time replacing less than 10 minutes.